Kenyatta Misericordia Hospital was started in 1962 by Sisters of Mercy, who were from Ireland. The first four Sisters of Mercy were invited by the then Archbishop of Nairobi. He was Archbishop McCarthy. And Archbishop McCarthy wanted the Sisters of Mercy to start an hospital for Africans.
It began in Caesarean, and over time it was began in South B, where at the time was one of the wasted lands. It was a swampy area.
It was a bit of a challenge in the beginning to get an ideal place to have a hospital for Africans. This is basically because we had a Khan hospital for Asians, with an Arab hospital for the Europeans, and the then King George Hospital, which is now Kenyatta National Hospital, which was a referral hospital.
Mater Misericordia is a faith-based hospital that provides exceptional healthcare services to patients.
Mater Misericordia Hospital is the main Catholic hospital in the country, which offers Christ-centered services to the patients.
Since its establishment in 1962, our main hospital, located along Dunga Road in South B, has undergone gradual improvement in standards as we continuously seek to satisfy the dynamic needs and preferences of our clients. The hospital is the first of its kind to receive ISO certification in East and Central Africa back in 2002, hence gaining status as a world-class hospital.
We are also committed to innovation, to research, and to best practice. So we have a wealth of knowledge that we are generating and using as a hospital, and in terms of how best to deliver the kind of care that is practical, that is state-of-the-art, that is world-class, but then it's also affordable and accessible to our patients.
It's a Christ-centered health institution. We pride ourselves for high-quality healthcare services and responsiveness in service delivery.
Any patient who comes to Mater is given unique care. We practice what we call primary nursing, and the primary nursing means that a nurse and meets a patient, takes care of that patient until discharge, and of course she's helped by other nurses, whom we call associate nurses. And in so doing, the nurses and the patient create a relationship that the patients are able to trust the nurses. And therefore, by the time they finish or by the time they get better, they have an experience of total holistic care.
Since it was started 58 years back, the hospital has remained true to the philosophy and values of the Sisters of Mercy, which ensures everyone receives quality medical services, irrespective of race, color, or creed.
Sisters of Mercy are known for quality because they are all over the world, and especially our care for the sick.
We are open to all patients of other denominations, even Muslims, because we try to bring the mercy of God to everybody, regardless of their religion.
We offer a wide range of medical services, including outpatient, inpatient, and general medical services.
We have inpatient services. We have a wide array of services, including surgical care, that is theaters. We have maternity, we have a thriving maternity unit with lots of mothers who come in through our care. We work with them through their pregnancies all the way to delivery. We have a nursery and a special care unit for our babies when they are born, and a pediatric unit for our children. We also have our general medicine, that is adult medicine. But we also have a critical care unit. We have an 18-bed capacity, so we are well able to take care of patients who probably are not able to breathe on their own, or who had major surgeries or trauma. And we have doctors who are qualified and equipped just taking care of these patients. We have a very competent nursing team that also takes care of these patients in these units. We also have our outpatient services, where we have our casualty. It's open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
True to our mission, we endeavor to deliver exceptional, compassionate, and Christ-centered healthcare services to our clients through an innovative, engaged, and competent workforce.
We also are a teaching hospital. We have a program for training surgical residents and interns. So we have a wide array of specialties in terms of doctors to take care of our patients. We also have a very competent nursing team. And within our nursing fraternity, we have basic nurses and we also have specialist nurses who have done advanced nursing care, either critical care nursing or renal nursing or midwifery, assigned in the different units of specialization. So these are the people that are there to work with the patient, to work with the family of whoever comes within our care to ensure that they get the safest and the most quality care that we can offer.
I'm Professor Ahmed Kiswezi. I'm a general surgeon. I work in this hospital as a general surgeon, but also as a trainer of the COSEXA residents. COSEXA is an abbreviation which stands for the College of Surgeons of East, Central and Southern Africa, and it trains doctors to become not only specialists but consultants in surgery. So far in this training site we have 9 residents who are being trained to become consultants, and we actually give them a variety of exposures, the theoretical knowledge plus the surgical skills in the skills lab, and also the theater procedures. Each year we admit 2 residents, and this year we are having hopefully the first batch of our finalists who are due to do their last part of exams to become fellows of the College of Surgeons of Eastern Central Africa.
I'm a COSEXA final year finalist, actually, general surgery. And it has been an interesting journey as regards to our program here at Mater Hospital. I myself and my colleague, Dr. Abubakar Swale, were the initial pioneer students or trainees in the program, COSEXA. So it has been an interesting 5-year journey towards us mastering the skill of general surgery, finally becoming qualified surgeons. And I can testify that with the training program in the hospital, we've actually seen improvement in patient care. We improved our standards, especially towards surgical care of patients, improved in having SOPCs, improving the general surgical patient care.
When Mater started initially, it was mainly maternity, and that is why it is called Mater Misericordia Hospital. Mater is a Latin word for mother, mother of mercy. Misericordia is mercy, mother of mercy hospital. We started with the maternity, and later on there was need to expand to other specialties, and that's why the hospital has expanded. And we have a big maternity wing, which takes care of the maternity cases, mainly the pregnant mothers and their newborn babies. We also have a pediatric ward, taking care of children.
My name is Rosalyn Oling. I'm the unit in charge of Mater Hospital Newborn Unit, Neonatal ICU and Special Care Unit. This is actually a 3-unit-into-1 that we take care of newborn units that are born with challenges. Sick newborns born before their time, those that come too early, those ones that are born very big and so therefore need monitoring, and those ones that have other challenges that need very close monitoring. This is where they belong. So they are taken care of here. They stay many days with us, and so we become their second parents or second mothers to them. In this unit, we work with a different multidisciplinary team, a big multidisciplinary team. We have a team of neonatal nurses, a team of neonatologists, pediatricians. We work together with physiotherapists that visit us and come to us when we call upon them, counselors that come and visit us because we have babies who stay here longer and therefore their parents need psychological care. And we also work with nutritionists who need to follow up these mothers so that we get milk that is beneficial to these babies. In this unit, we have equipment that are beneficial to these babies. From birth, we have resuscitation equipment. We have very well-manufactured and well-maintained incubators, ventilators to take care of babies who have difficulties in breathing. I can say that we have managed to take care of very small ones from 26 weeks gestation, and they have managed to go home. They're very happy. Some of them are doing very well and with no complications in life. We have also managed to take care of very small ones from 600 grams. And they are now very big babies. In this unit, yes, we managed to get visiting consultants because of different specialties. We also work with doctors who are able to look at the baby's eyes, because for these babies who come too early, they have challenges with their eyes and other organs as well. So we invite in other neonatologists, other specialists who come in and actually take care of these babies for them to be able to grow well, just like any other children in the community. We managed to counsel these mothers to a point where they're able to take care of these babies. We've been able to nurture them and be able to give them confidence that they're able to look after these babies even back at home. We're actually best known for the best neonatal care, basically for prematurity care. Our babies, when we receive these babies, as I have said, we have mothers who have different challenges. And because they have challenges with these pregnancies, their babies come too early. So you find these obstetricians sending to us the mothers to come and deliver to deliver in our facilities, and we take care of their babies, and babies do very well. So we are well known for neonatal prematurity care. The ICU is 6-bedded, and then we have the rest are 10 beds for special care unit, which is actually also known as neonatal HDU. We are known to offer the best Christ-centered care, so we welcome each and every mother to come to us so that we can actually take care of their newborns. Kangaroo is done for the preterm babies. The mother's warmth is the best warmth. We have set a time for Kangaroo. For us here, we do it in the afternoon at 2 p.m. So in that particular time, we provide for them seats, comfortable seats, and we give them Kangaroo gowns.
The hospital is a competitive training institution in nursing education, including post-basic midwifery training, innovation, research, and professionalism.
We are a nursing school that was started way back in 1972, chartered as a midwifery school. The school is run by a highly qualified faculty. All the departments, for example, you look at midwifery, it's headed by someone with a PhD in midwifery. Critical care is headed by a highly specialized person with a master's in critical care. Nephrology, the same. Our clinical instructors for these programs are also specialized in their various fields. We have good facilities for our training. We have a very well equipped skills laboratory. This is for all the programs, both the basic diploma, the Kenya Registered Nursing, the midwifery, the critical care. We have a very well equipped skills laboratory.
Licensed and accredited by the Nursing Council of Kenya, Catherine Macaulay Nursing School has continuously maintained high quality performance by offering holistic training in nursing and producing qualified and competent professionals who understand, espouse, and respect the sacredness of human life.
The Nursing Council of Kenya accredited it to offer nursing programs. We have various programs. We have general nursing, that is the Kenya Registered Nurse. We have higher diplomas in Kenya Registered Midwifery, Kenya Registered Critical Care Nurses, Kenya Registered Nephrology Nurse, and also we have Theatre Nursing, which is called Kenya Registered Perioperative Nursing. We do admit our students from all over the country, especially for the basic diploma, that is the Kenya Registered Nurse Program. And for higher diplomas, we admit, again, we have a Pan-African presence. We have students from Congo, from Rwanda, from Uganda, and from other countries. But basically, most of our students are Kenyan, those ones who have graduated from our Kenyan institutions.
Established in 1972, Catherine Macaulay Nursing School has tremendously grown in the field of nursing.
Our higher diplomas are for those nurses who are willing to specialize in a specific field. So this is a highly specialized courses. For example, the critical care program equips nurses who are able to work in high dependency units, that is the critical care units. The perioperative program trains nurses who are very specialized in surgical and theater procedures. The nephrology nursing program produces nurses who are specialized in renal matters.
Nursing is a noble profession because we work with our clients at different stages of their lives, right from birth up to end of life. When a baby is born, a nurse is present. When a baby is brought to receive vaccines, a nurse is present. When you fall ill, the nurse is by your side. And even at the end of life, a nurse is present. So we are there to give our services throughout each stages of human life.
Mater Misericordia Hospital prides itself in its cardiac program that raises funds through the annual Mater Heartron event to support needy patients. The cardiac department was started in 1995 with the main objective of providing quality treatment to patients with heart illnesses and disorders.
The cardiac program coordinates the care of patients with cardiac ailments in the hospital, planning the surgeries, especially for those who cannot afford the care, planning any procedures like in cath lab, and also coordinating their care in ICU.
The Mater Heartron campaign continues to help and call for support for patients with cardiac complications by attracting donors and stakeholders to cushion patients who need to undergo surgery but are otherwise unable to meet the cost of the medical procedures.
I am happy to introduce to you one of our cardiac program beneficiaries, Amos Mutiso. He came to the hospital in 2009 when he was just 12 years old, and he was diagnosed with tricuspid atresia. And when they were told about the cost and everything, somehow they got lost to follow up. And that time he was doing well. The symptoms were not as severe. But after 10 years, that is 2019, last year, he came back now and he was having severe symptoms, getting breathless and his blood thickening, so that we had to do venesection now and again. But he did not have any money and there was no beneficiary for him. So through the Mater Cardiac Program, the hospital has sponsored him. And he has undergone a CT scan of the pulmonary anatomy, and it showed that he could be assisted by doing Glenn procedure. He has done very, very well. Show us your fingers like this, the other side, yeah, this way. These fingers were all blue before we did the procedure. But now after the shunt, you can see they are going to normal. They are turning pink, meaning that he has good perfusion. He can tell you how he feels, how he used to feel a long time ago, and how far he has come to be where he is.
natoka Huruma, Madare constituency. So nilikuja kwa mata nikiwa mdogo sana, nilikuwa na suffer heart problem. Sasa ile mamangu angeweza ku raise nini pesa za surgery, nikakuja kwanza nilipotea juu alisema hiyo pesa ni mingi sana, kwa tafuta wasaidizi nikakosa, gari kwenda shule bado ilikuwa shida. So nilikuja pa last year kuongea na sister, akasema anaweza ni support. Ndio tukaanza ma procedure, alikuwa ananibaya dawa, hata transport alikuwa anasimamia saa zingine haukuja, bado anaweza kunisaidia hadi nifanywa surgery.
It's one of the ways that the Mater Hospital is able to reach out and touch a child's heart wherever they are.
Ningetaka kushukuru sister, Professor Joy, Dr. Gladys Njiha, wamenipa support all those years. Wamenitoa nyasi karibu. Bado Mater yenyewe naishukuru sana. Nishika mkono. Wako ni babua pale natoka manini.
These are the poor children who cannot afford surgery and who cannot go to abroad. So by the event of the annual Mat Heart Run, the funds and also money from well-wishers, these monies are used to assist these children.
And since we do so many surgeries and we still have a big waiting list, we vet our patients so that patients or families pay what they can afford. Then if they have any NHIF, which we encourage all of them to register, NHIF has been very gracious. It has been undertaking cardiac surgery, open heart surgery. They have been giving some amount. Sometimes they give even up to 500,000. Then the relatives raise what they can raise, and then the program pays the other cost. Apart from patient care, the cardiac program also coordinates the outreach program, that is like the CSR for the program, whereby we go for medical camps, and during these medical camps we screen children below the age of 18, that is the school going children, for heart ailments.
Mater Hospital has a well-equipped and efficient comprehensive care center that provides specialized prognosis and care to HIV patients.
This is a donor-funded project. Currently, our donor is from PEPFAR through the Center for Disease Control, that's CDC. We receive the funds through Christian Hospital Association of Kenya. And because of these funds, we are able to offer free HIV services to anybody who comes to the clinic. So the clinic operates every Monday to Friday from 7 a.m. to 4 p.m. We offer HIV testing and counseling. We also offer treatment. We offer ARVs for our patients for free.
It matters. Respect to all is paramount as one of our core values. We are therefore able to meet patients at their point of need and attend to them in a special way.
What this clinic does, basically, it takes care of the HIV/AIDS clients, mainly from the slums. Again, this department is in line with our mission of mercy, to take care of the underprivileged.
The Mater Hospital is right adjacent to the Mukuru slum. And the project started to offer HIV care and treatment for patients from the Mukuru slums. We offer treatment for other illnesses. We offer cancer screening, that's cervical cancer screening, for free. We also offer counseling services and nutrition services. For those who are very needy, we also offer food support and other social support. A driver of HIV infection is sexual violence. As a response to this, the Mater Hospital opened a sexual gender-based violence recovery center where people can access free services for sexual after they have been sexually violated. This is run from the Accident and Emergency Center at the Mater Hospital, and all the services offered for a client who has been sexually violated are free. Again, this service is open to everybody, not just clients from Mukuru, but from all over Nairobi or outside.
We are concerned about your spiritual, psychological, and social well-being. Hence, we have the Pastoral Care and Mission Department, which makes our services complete by taking care of your mental and social aspects of life.
Pastoral care is an integral part of health care. It's an integral part of healing. And through pastoral care, we commit ourselves to holistic healing and a faith vision of life, bearing in mind that Mater Misericordiae Hospital is a faith-based institution with a Catholic identity. Chaplaincy plays an important role in the spiritual welfare of our patients, their families, and also the staff and students of Catherine Macaulay Nursing School. The celebration of sacraments, the Eucharist, anointing of the sick, there is baptism in danger of death. And in this, we collaborate with the parish of Our Lady, Queen of Peace, since we are a chaplaincy. The chaplains also take Holy Communion to the patients in the wards. And the chaplains also do ward rounds where they meet and engage the patients and their families. As regards the Eucharist, we have daily Mass at the hospital chapel every day at 1 p.m., Mondays to Friday. On Saturday, the Holy Mass is celebrated at 9 a.m. And on Sunday, the Holy Mass is celebrated at 11 a.m. On public holidays, the Holy Mass is celebrated at 9 a.m. When the Mass is being celebrated, it is also being broadcast to the wards and some offices for the benefit of those who have not made it to the chapel to celebrate Mass in person. We have counselors that take care of family issues, counselors that take care of youth issues, and also counselors that take care of the issues like drug abuse and other types of abuses, issues of violence, issues of mental health, and also the counselors provide psychological guidance and give input on educational issues about psychosocial issues. One of the works that they do day in, day out is offering counseling sessions to individuals and also to groups whenever that is possible. They also carry out sessions, counseling sessions for couples preparing for marriage. They also do outreach seminars, and these are carried out in churches and in schools, the main target being families and the youth.
Mater Hospital has a state-of-art ISO-certified general laboratory and the soon-to-be-launched molecular laboratory, which will enable our team of pathologists to test a wide range of both minor and major infectious diseases and terminal illnesses.
Our hospital also has a state-of-the-art lab, which is ISO-certified, and we offer quite an array of services, including molecular lab testing, which is an opportunity for us to test for viruses including COVID-19, HIV, hepatitis B, and other such viruses. We're also able to do cancer diagnostics, for example, to type the kinds of breast cancer or other kinds of cancers. So that is available in our laboratory.
Quality assurance is very important in laboratory. Our laboratory is accredited to ISO 15189. This is a specific ISO for medical laboratories. That means we are internationally recognized globally, that our laboratory is able and is competent to carry the tests of patients. The laboratory is staffed with very senior staff. We have 5 consultants, pathologists who cover the departments on consultation basis. We have very senior technologists who do the sample analysis. We have the phlebotomists who collect the blood samples all around the hospital. We are engaged in external quality assurance program, which is called HUCAS, where we get samples from them, we analyze and send them online, then they give us a report on our performance. Laboratory is an integral part of a hospital where we provide confirmatory diagnosis to the clinicians. We help in monitoring of treatment. We provide blood and blood products for transfusion. And in the morgue, we preserve bodies. We do embalming and postmortem. In Mater Hospital, we have laboratories in all our medical centers, and the main laboratory is in the main hospital.
We also have consultant clinics such as orthopedic, gynecology, rheumatology, oncology, ENT surgery clinic, among others, which provide specialized medical services to patients.
And these consultant clinics have all the specialties, be it medicine, surgery, neurology, cardiac, be it ENT, gynae, we have all that.
Consultants clinics, stroke the specialized clinics, we take care of a wide range of clients, medical and surgical patients. Medical patients being followed up through discharges from the wards, and those who are being referred for specialized follow-up care in our different medical clinics. We have the dermatology clinics, we have the hematology clinics, we have the rheumatology clinic, which is a very demanding clinic. We also have neurology clinic, just to mention but a few. For the surgical clinics, we have a vast breast clinic which is run by a specialized surgeon. We prepare patients for different surgeries, orthopedic surgeries, general surgeries, pediatric surgical procedures, and also ophthalmology procedures. We also have an ophthalmology clinic which is run by highly specialized ophthalmologists. And among them, we have a retina specialist who is taking care of patients with retina issues.
I'm Dr. Callisto Odongo. I've been an orthopedic consultant in Mata since 2002. I usually see patients in the orthopedic consultant clinic. I do the operations on orthopedic conditions and also trauma. We also do take students in training on orthopedics. We train orthopedic registrars who eventually become consultants and serve everywhere else in the country.
We have accident and emergency, and that is actually the door of the hospital where we receive patients when they come with different ailments, and from there they are either treated and discharged to go home, or they are admitted in relevant wards, depending on what is their issue.
We at Dental Clinic of Mater Hospital offer very compassionate and comprehensive dental treatment in all aspects of dentistry. As you all know, that taking care of your teeth is very important, and at Mata, we offer from basic to most advanced dentistry, such as periodontic dentistry, where we take care of your bleeding gums, swollen gums, and we also do restorative dentistry, where we're mainly concerned with filling the decayed teeth and saving those teeth. We also offer more advanced root canal treatment, where we try to save a tooth which otherwise needs to be extracted by an endodontic treatment. We also have visiting consultant maxillofacial surgeons who offer all aspects of maxillo surgery, dealing with trauma, tumors, etc.
The hospital management has greatly invested in the radiology department with cutting-edge equipment to ensure accuracy and efficiency in diagnosis and treatment, earning us a steady repute.
In our department, we provide various imaging services, including MRI, CT scan, ultrasounds, mammography, among others. Our CT scanner is 128 slices and is capable of carrying out cardiac imaging, which includes coronary analysis and calcium scoring, as well as CT guided biopsies and various angiography imaging. A 1.5T MRI scanner is capable of carrying out cardiac imaging, mammography, among all the rest. This is because the hospital has invested in softwares in this scanner. We also provide high-end ultrasound services, including 4D scanning, which many mothers always love to see how their baby looks like when it's in the uterus, and other ultrasound imaging. We also do provide OPG, that is dental x-ray equipment that is able to take the whole mouth in one go, and as well as the temporomandibular joints, the joints that we find here. We are also providing imaging services during surgery in theater, as well as the ICU, patients who cannot come to the main department. We have highly qualified personnel, which includes radiologists, sonographers, and radiographers, as well as support staff. Mata is renowned for quality services and good customer care.
Our theatre unit is fully fledged with modern medical facilities and enough spacious operating suites that certify orderly and timely services.
In theatre, we have 5 operating theatres, and the 60th one is in maternity, just next to maternity theatre, where the mothers have to be operated like right away without waste of time. I have a good number of staff. And I have 28 nurses. I have a group of technicians who are 7. I have anesthetist assistants, 10 of them. And I also have porters who help us bring the patients. And there are 10 of them also. So we work as a team. I would say my team is a good team. In the theatres, we do all the surgeries, all of them, every specialty we do. But specifically, I would say we are doing well with cardiac surgery, whereby we've had even exchange programs for cardiac surgery. And right here where we are standing is also theater, which we use for cardiac operations. I would say we do a lot of them, because we do like 6 to 10 in a week. And at the end of the year, you find that all the teams are able to assist in heart surgery. The other thing we are good at is also the laparoscopy, we have the next operating room is for laparoscopy, whereby we call keyhole surgery. We have the state-of-the-art tower from Olympus, and we are able to do general surgery. We are also able to do obs-gyne in laparoscopy, especially for young girls. They don't have to be cut and have big incisions to have their surgery done. So we usually use the keyhole surgery. And the girls are happy because even the recovery time is very short. We also do plastic surgery. We also do endoscopies. We do gynecological operations. And also, as they grow up, because you start with the general, for us to say general surgery, it means you can do anything which is general, be it an abdomen, be it an eye, be it an arm, a limb. Orthopedics, we are also good in orthopedics because we are able to do even some workshops like arthroscopies. For joints, we usually do some workshops like one or two in a year, and that has helped the team to grow. What guides what we do is the bookings. When the bookings tell us we have this specialty or the other specialty, we are able to allocate theaters to cater for each specialty without mixing. That is how we run our theater, and we also get our clients, private and hospital.
We have a team of highly competent and dedicated surgeons, both from within and abroad, who deal with major and complex surgical operations.
We have own doctors here for hospital patients, the anesthetists, the surgeons. We have some employed by the hospital, but we are lucky to say that we are working with a lot of consultants who are very best in every specialty, and that has helped the team to grow and also the hospital. When you come with a fracture like in the femur, we don't have to put screws, we put some nails, and you're able to heal very fast. We are also able to do the ENT surgeries. ENT is whereby ear, nose and throat, you'll find the surgeon using towers that even the assistant is able to see what is happening. We have the state-of-the-art tower that is able to see the body organs the way they are. Sometimes even some surgeries like urology also, we do them under spinal anesthesia, whereby the patient is not sleeping completely, and as we operate, they are also able to see what we are doing on the screen. Move the thyroid gland, it will take you, we have machines that will help us reduce the operation time from 1.5 hours to 30 minutes. So that helps the patient recovery because the short stay in recovery and also in the ward. There are many other surgeries that we do. That even the daycare procedures, we do a lot of in daycare procedures where we do diagnostic procedures. And we've seen a number growing. We do about 150 in a month. Mr. Jenny here is cutting pre-tech, the swabs we use on the patients. So that is what he's preparing. We prepare them.
Okay.
So he is allocated today to take care of all the instruments that are going to be used and also assess what we need for tomorrow, the day for tomorrow.
We have a functional, fully furnished and well-resourced physiotherapy section and a team of therapists who attend to patients with body tissue deformities and injuries.
We have quite a vibrant physiotherapy unit in the main hospitals, and in some of our satellite units we have several satellite centers where you can get physiotherapy services just to support the medication and the other kind of treatment that we get for, say, back pain or developmental. We have occupational therapies, speech therapies and such kind of units that just support the main medical delivery of services.
Physiotherapy, also known as physical therapy, is a mode of treatment for injuries, disorders, or diseases through physical means. In the Mata Hospital, we have physiotherapy as in the outpatient department. We have also in the inpatient department. We also have satellite clinics from the Karen, Westlands, Thika and Town Clinic. We also have as a whole department occupational therapy as part of rehabilitative department.
As Mata Misericordia Hospital, we are committed to be a leading healthcare provider in East and Central Africa and to benchmark ourselves against the highest attainable world-class standards as we seek continuous improvement.
This hospital can be any hospital in the UK or in the USA. It is well furnished and has everything that we need to take care of every patient. We have plans in the future to build a new block, and that block will include a private ward, modern private ward, so that those who really want private services and they can afford will be able to nurse them in that ward.
In a bid to get our medical services closer to you, we have operational satellite clinics in Buruburu Phase 3, Nairobi Central Business District on Development House, at Kenrell Towers in Westlands, Kasarani at TRM Mall, at Shujaa Mall along Spine Road in Kayole, in Thika Town, and the newly launched branch at the Well Mall in Karen.
We have 7 satellite clinics spread out across the city. So in all these medical centers, anybody can access our services and the support that you'd get in the main hospital in South B. The same quality of standard of care is available and accessible to you in our satellite medical center. So, karibu to Mata.
We perform to the best of our ability to achieve the highest attainable standards.
Our core purpose is to meet each client at their point of need. Because clients are from different backgrounds, they come with different needs, and therefore we endeavor to meet each one of them at their point of need. That's what we exist for.
At Mata, we provide care that is with a difference. Care that has compassion in it. Care with excellence. Care that is Christ-centeredness. There's one quote of Mother Teresa that I find very good and I apply it in my nursing profession. That it is not how much you do, but how much love you put in the doing. The word to underline there is love. Nurses at the Mata Hospital love what they do.
We not only take care of the patient, we take care of our family. We believe that when there is a patient in a family, the whole family is also suffering. And therefore, we give holistic care of the patient as well as the family.
Mata Misericordia Hospital, we are always ready to help you and your family.